bread, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My Father and my God, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord Almighty, you are a great God. You are wonderful. We thank you for this time, God. We thank you to this midnight, Lord. We honor you, God. You are a wonderful Father. You are a great God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Amen. 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 Amen and amen. Yes, we thank God for everything. We give him glory. We give him honor. Yes. Today I'm going to talk to you the subject very, 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 very difficult. And this topic, many people, many people, they have been victimized. Many people have been attacked. They have been suffering because of the powers of chance and witchcraft spells attacks. Witchcraft spells attacks. Prayer against chance and witchcraft spells attack. Yes, these are the powers that witchcraft are using. They are the weapons of witchcraft. Prayer against chance and witchcraft spells attacks. I'm going to read from the book of Matthew. Yes, hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, we thank God. My God, I want to thank you so much. I want to worship you and honor you, God. You are so good. I'm going to read from the book of Matthew 2, verse 3 to 7. Matthew 2, verse 3 to 7. This is the story. Everybody knows how the witchcraft, chants, and spells almost killed Jesus. I want to show you examples how that spells and chants did not work in the life of Jesus. I'm going to show you two examples how chants and chants or witchcraft spells attacks, and two examples of chants and witchcraft attacks where they worked. As I'm going to read from you the book of Matthew 2, chapter 2, verse 3 to 7, the Bible says, when Herod, the king, heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and the scribes of the people together, he inquired of them which where Christ should be born. They told him, in Bethlehem of Judea, for this is what the prophet wrote, and you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are no longer less among the princes of Judea, for out of you shall come a governor who will shepherd my people Israel. Then Herod, when he had privately called the wise men carefully, inquired of them what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, go and search intelligently for the young child. And when you have found him, bring me a word so that I may come and worship him also. You know, when Herod heard Jesus was born, he was troubled. He felt bad. He didn't sleep. He didn't eat. He was thinking how to kill Jesus, how to get rid of Jesus. Herod had troubled himself, and he tried witchcraft. He tried a chance. He tried spells. He tried reincarnation, but it didn't work. So he sent his wise, intelligent people to go and fetch the child. And he lied to them that if you find him, let me know so that I can go and worship him. But that was a lie. He wanted to kill him. That's how bad it is. When something good is happening to somebody, when you are born, your star is in. Then you trouble witchcraft. You make evil people to feel bad. Then the witchcraft will start attacking your star. They will lay incarnation. They will put gents against you. They will curse you. They will not have peace until they get destroyed. They destroy you. Now, the witchcraft, chants, incarnation, and all spells didn't work in Jesus. So the angel of the Lord appeared to the parents of Jesus and told Jesus, get out of this place. The enemy, Herod, wants to kill you. Run up, run for your life. So the parents took Jesus to Egypt and hid him until Herod died. So when Herod died, the same angel appeared to the parents of Jesus and told him, return your child. The enemy is dead. So your enemy will die in the name of Jesus. Every enemy that wants to destroy you, enemy that does not want anything from you, let that enemy die. The enemy died. The enemy wanted to kill Jesus died. So your enemy is going to die in the name of Jesus. Look at the Bible from the book of Acts, to Acts 9 verse 23. The book of Acts 9 23. That is another example. That chants and spells and witchcraft attack did not work. After many days he had passed, the Jews conspired to him to kill him. In the book of Acts, 9:23-24. The Bible says, and after many days had passed, the Jews conspired to him to kill him. But Saul ran of their plot. But Saul, even before Saul could, his name could be changed, they planned to kill him. The Bible says, Saul ran of their plot. When Saul ran their plot, when Saul noticed that they want to kill him, what did Saul did? Saul prayed and stopped their witchcraft, their powers, their chants, their spells, and Paul prayed and said, you cannot kill me in the name of Jesus. So Paul stand against their witchcraft, their powers, and prayed. The Bible says, but Saul learned of their abroad day and night. They watched the city gates in order to kill him. Now, first Acts 23, verse 21, the Bible says, do not let them persecute you, because more than 40 men are waiting to ambush him. They have bound themselves with an altar not to eat or drink until they have killed him. They are ready now, waiting your consent. You see, now the people, 40 men, they deny themselves not to eat until they see Paul is dead, until they kill Paul. These are the people who said they will not eat. So they tried their witches, they tried their chants, they tried everything to see that they have killed Paul. Even Paul was, his name was not changed. He was called Saul that time. Now they say that they are going to kill him. Why? Because they have seen something good is coming to Paul. So they want to kill Paul before Paul achieve what God has called him for. And that's what is happening. Before you achieve anything, the witchcraft will make sure that they will work. They will make sure they finish you. They will make sure they will kill you physically or spiritually. They will work and make sure. You see, they said they will not eat. When they were not, if they are not eating for those three, I don't know how many days, they said they will not eat until they said Paul is dead. Now, they were, after all this, they were not worshiping God. They were not praying God. They were chanting. They were cursing. They were putting spells. They were putting chants. Chants is bad luck. Chants is to curse you. Chants is to put spells, evil spells on a person. when chains has is been placed on a person, the person become useless. Now with Paul, because he understood how to attack their witches, he prayed and arrested every witchcraft and all chains, spells, and incarnation that it rained on him. Nothing happened, and then Paul escaped like Jesus escaped. So they didn't find him. May God make you to escape from the hands of your enemies. May God run you out of the hands of the witchcraft, hands of the enemy that have vowed, that have swear that they will finish you. My God, may the Lord Almighty cover you from the hands of witchcraft, from the powers of spells and chants, from the enemy that is working in your life and your children. My God, I pray that God will deliver you. It is a night of deliverance from chants and spells and witchcraft attacks. Many people, they are under witchcraft spells attacks. When you are being in an evil spells, you become blind. You become deaf. You don't see anything. Let's look another scripture. The person who was witched and the witch succeeded to destroy his life. A witch, they put spells on him. They put chants. A chant was put in this person and he succeeded and entered and destroyed his life. And he was a man. He was a man of God. Let's look at the book of Judges. The book of Judges 16 to 7, 16 from 4 to 17. You read the whole thing, but I want to talk about what happened. What happened? Judges 16, 4 to 17. Samson had been more than once brought into mischief and danger by the love of a woman. You see, Samson, a man of God, was spells, was chants, and it was put witchcraft, spells, and a wicked power from the woman. This woman, Dalila. Now, Samson has been more than once brought into mischief and danger by the love of a woman. Yet he could not take warning, but is again take in the same snare. And this third times is frontal, licenseless, is one of the things that take away the heart. This is a deep pit and which many have fallen, but from which few have escaped, and those by a miracle of mercy. Like Paul escaped because of the miracle of mercy, the mercy of God. But many people are put into and fall on this. Hallelujah. With the loss of reputation and the useless of almost fall except their soul, the anxious of suffering is 10 times greater than all the pressure of the sins. Now, here is the woman, a witch, who used chants and evil spells to Samson. He spells on Samson. Once you are being spells, no matter what a person do to you, you don't see. Once a man is being spells with a woman, the woman can sleep with another man, and the man will never say anything. He will never say anything. Even if you tell him your wife is with a man right here, look at that, the man will say no. The man will be like useless, like anything else, and he can tell the woman every secret because he's under influence of spells and witchcraft manipulation. Now, the writer in Judges 16 verse 6 told Samson very clearly. He told Samson, show me your secret, where you put your power. And because of this chance and spells, witchcraft manipulation, Samson did not realize or say, why should I saw this woman where I keep my secret strength? Why? But look at that scripture. In the book of Judges 16 verse 6, the Bible says, And Delilah said to Samson, tell me, I pray you, where your great strength lies and with what might be bound to afflict you, that I may torture you, afflict you. She gave answer. But Samson, because he was being attacked by spells, manipulation, witchcraft, chants, Samson could not realize, could not think of anything. A woman witched him and manipulated him completely that he could not even think of anything. Then after Samson tried to lie to Delilah a little bit, but the woman was constantly insisting, telling him, please show me. And then at the end, Samson revealed secret to the enemy. May the Lord deliver you by the power that created the heaven and the earth. May God deliver you not to reveal your secret to the enemies. Not to reveal, not to tell the secret to your enemies. Not to give your information to witchcraft who wants to turn and destroy you. Yes, Lord, my Father. God, I want to thank you, God. May the cover of God, may the blood of Jesus Christ cover you from giving the enemy your secret. Now, after Samson gave this woman, a witch, the secret where he puts his strength, what happened? They destroyed him. Samson was destroyed completely. He was punished. He died with those people. May God deliver you not to die with your enemies. Let your enemy that is following you, who is using spells and chants over your life, let them be dead. Let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I am very angry because I know many, many, many people are being attacked. When you are doing something and you shut your friend, they will not sleep. Look at what happened to Paul, Saul. The 40 men decide not to eat until they see Paul is dead. There's some people, when they hear something is going to happen to you, they will go to witchcraft, they will put a spell on you, they will chant on you, they will make sure that you miss that thing, or they have killed you. They will rise up, they will not be happy until they see you are missed. When you are put under spells, under enchants, that is what happened. Then, like Samson, become a fool, become a stupid. Even when the woman said that I will torture you, I will bind your affection. This is, but the man was not listening. He didn't think why is that the woman wants to torture me? Why should she say the truth? Let's look at another example whereby a man of God, a prophet, was killed by another prophet because of spells and chants that worked on the prophet. Let's look in the book of 2 Kings 13, verse 1 to 27. I am going to read, and this video is going to be wrong, but by the grace of God, we'll do it the better thing, which will deliver you and your family. Yes, Lord. Now, 1 Kings 13, chapter 13, from verse 1 to 27. The Bible says, a man of God came out of Judea to Bethel by the word of the Lord, while Jeroboam stood by the altar to burn incense. He cried against the altar by the word of the Lord and said, O altar, altar, thus says the Lord, a child named Joash will be born in the house of David, and he will sacrifice upon you the priests of the high places, who burn incense on you, and the men's bones shall be burned upon you. He gave a sign the same day, saying, this is the sign that the Lord has spoken. The altar will tear apart, and the ashes that are upon it will be poured out. When King Jeroboam heard the saying of the man of God who had cried against the altar in Bethel, he reached out his hand from the altar, saying, "Arrest him." And the hand that he put forth against him dried up so that he could not pull it back in again. The altar also thawed, and the ash boiled out from the altar, just as the man of God had said it would be, as a sign of the Lord. The king asked and said to the man of God, "Seek the face of the Lord your God and pray for me that my hand will heal." And the man of God interceded with the Lord, and the king's hand was healed and became as it was before. Yes, you see? The king said to the man of God, "Come home with me and refresh yourself, and I will give you a reward." The man of God said to the king, "If you were to give me a half of your house, I would not go with you, nor would I rest bread, nor would I eat bread or drink water in this place. For so I was commanded by the word of the Lord, saying, 'You shall eat no bread, nor drink water, nor return by the same way that you came.'" So he went another way and did return by the same way he came to Bethel. Now, here is a witch, a whole prophet, a witch, put a chance and spells against the man of God. Then the man of God came like Herod. You know, Herod lied to a wise man, saying that they want to go and he wants to go and worship Jesus. But it was a lie. He wanted to kill Jesus. So now here is a witch, a proper witch, that when he heard what happened to the young prophet, this prophet, the whole prophet, didn't sleep. He just think, "How can I destroy this man? How can I destroy this young prophet?" Now he lied to a young prophet, and they went and deceived him, because he used chants and spells and a witchcraft attack. He attacked this old prophet. The old prophet attacked the young prophet, and now this young prophet, he didn't think and respond and stop this old prophet. But because of witchcraft, many people have been attacked by witchcraft spells, and they succeed to destroy your life. Many people are suffering because of witchcraft spells attacks. Some they die physically, some they become useless, some they lose very important things that they were supposed to get. Now the Bible says, "Now there lived an old prophet in Bethel, and his sons came and told him all that the man of God has done that day in Bethel. They also told their father the words that he spoke to the king. Their father said to them, 'What way did he go?' For his son had seen the way the man of God who came from Judea has gone. He said to his sons, 'Suddenly, my donkey. So they added the donkey for him, and he rode on it. He went after the man of God and found him sitting under the oak, and they said to him, 'Are you the man of God who came from Judea?' The man of God said, he said, "I am." Then he said to him, "Come home with me and eat bread." He said, "I may not return with you or go in with you, nor will I eat bread nor drink water with you in this place. For I was commanded by the Lord, by the word of the Lord, 'You shall eat no bread and drink no water there, nor return by the way you came.'" Now, this prophet, the whole prophet, is referring secret to the young prophet is referring secret to the whole prophet who doesn't want him. Now, when the prophet heard so, he said, look at what the old prophet said to the young prophet. He said to him, I am a prophet like you, and an angel spoke to me by the word of the Lord, saying, bring him back with you unto your house, so that he may eat bread and drink water. But he had lied to him. So he went back with him to his house and ate bread and drink water. You see, this old prophet lied to the young prophet and said that the angel of God has spoken through the Lord. And now this prophet did not address this witch the way he told Jeroboam. When he told Jeroboam, I will not drink even if you give me a half of your household. He said so. So now, the prophet, because this old prophet used chance, spells, witchcraft attack to attack this young prophet. And it worked. Because he told him that I am a prophet like you. And this young prophet, he didn't take a step to pray or seek God before. He confirmed from God before he could say yes. When your spells attacks, when you are being put in chains or spells, that's how you become. You don't think properly. I met a prophet in the internet. The prophet was almost deceived me, nearly destroyed my life completely. But because I don't go with the prophets that I don't know. I have to seek God. I have to find out, is it really a man of God? Or who is this person? So I told God, God, if this man for sure is your servant, let me know before I commit myself to him. Now, when I was praying that, I saw this prophet. Then when I God revealed to me who he is. So I say, okay, God, thank you. Now, I was taking care and handling him very carefully, because I know he's a cult, he's a witch using the name of God. Remember, the Bible says, many will use my name. They will call stars from heaven. This prophet was like that. He is a false prophet, he's a cult, he's an old prophet like this one. Nearly, if I did not seek God, I could not be here today. I could have died. He could have finished me completely. Now, then as they sit at the table, the word of the Lord came to the prophet who brought him back. And he cried out to the man of God who came from Judea, saying, thus says the Lord, since you have disobeyed the mouth of the Lord and you have not kept the commandment that the Lord your God commanded you, but instead came back and have eaten bread and drink water in the place which the Lord told you to eat not bread and drink not water, your carcass will not be buried in the tomb of your father. And he had eaten bread and had drink. He saddled the donkey from the prophet whom he had brought back. As he was going, a lion met him on the way and killed him. And his body was thrown onto the road, and both the donkey and lion stood by it. Some men passed by and saw the body thrown in the road with the lion standing by and the body, and they came and told the story in the city where the old prophet lived. When the prophet who brought him back from the way he heard about, he said, it is the man of God who was disobedient to the word of the Lord, and thus the Lord has delivered him to the lion who has torn and stained him, according to the word of the Lord that he spoke to him. He said to the sons, saddle my donkey, and they saddled it. He went and found his body thrown in the road, and picked up the body of the man of God and laid on his donkey and brought it back. The whole prophet came to the city, mourned to bear him. He laid his body in his own tomb and mourned over him, saying, has my brother. Now he's calling him my brother. He's calling him my brother after he has killed him. He is the one who is was responsible for his death. He killed him. Now he called him my brother. You see, when you are spells and chants and witchcraft attack, you don't realize. You don't think properly. That is how the man of God, the young prophet, vanished. That is how the young prophet was destroyed by old prophet. You see, that's how many, many, many people, they are attacked by witchcraft, spells, attack, and chants. I am praying to you tonight, every power that is following you, every power that is following you to destroy your life, let them die. Let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I am going to pray for you that God will deliver you and your family and your children. Every evil witchcraft that is following you to destroy your life, let them die in the name of Jesus. Let your environment become too hot for any private enemies in the name of Jesus. Let your environment become too hot for any private enemies that is following you to destroy your life and your children. In the mighty name of Jesus, environmental witchcraft. Environmental witchcraft using chance, space witchcraft attack over your life and your children. Let them die. Let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Let all friendly witchcraft power be exposed and disgraced in the name of Jesus. Witchcraft chants and spells that is attacking you, let them be exposed and disgraced in the name of Jesus. I pray by the power in the blood of Jesus. Let all friendly witchcraft power be exposed and disgraced in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every corporation of the spirit of darkness around you, I scatter them. I scatter them, I bound them, I destroy them. Every chance, spells, and witchcraft incarnation over your life, I destroy them. I bind them, I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. I pray that God, Almighty God, let your right expose every hidden evil structure. Yes, my God. Lord, let your light expose every hidden evil structure planted around you in the name of Jesus. The structure that enemy is planning, every hidden, like what this wicked old prophet made the young prophet die and lose the blessings of God. It deceived him. He lied on him. But because he wished him, he sent spells on him. That's what happens. Spells, enchants, and witchcraft, they are even in the churches. Pastors are using the same chants, the same spells, witchcraft to attack their victims. Let those power die in the name of Jesus. You shall rest and go forth in the name of Jesus. Any evil tree planted around you, be uprooted in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray any evil tree planted around you, be uprooted in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I dismantle the powers of stealing from the garden of your life in the name of Jesus. Every power stealing your blessings, stealing your vision, stealing your calling, stealing your blessings, let this power die. Let them be scattered. Let them be rendered powerless in the name of Jesus. Every evil gathered against you, against your calling, against your life, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I know somebody. This person was successfully working very hard. She did very well. She had a store. She had a wholesale. And she was selling almost the whole town. The whole city were getting some stuff from her store. Now, then there were some wicked powers of darkness, witchcraft. When they were looking how to destroy that woman, they were thinking how to do it. They went and started spells. How? Because the woman was not talking to people. She was concerned and committed to her work. And she was successful. She was doing very well. Then the wicked went to chants and spells, witchcraft attack, because they were not sleeping. They were thinking how to destroy her. Then one day they went with a very good idea to telling her that, you know, there is big business in overseas and you can sell things there and there's a big market that if you can open the store in overseas, the whole world would be buying your stuff. Because of spells and chants, then the woman said, yes, I think that is a good idea. And then these people, they went and told the woman to bank some money to their account so that they can open the bank account, they can operate and license and everything. So the woman did so, what these people told her, without consulting, without praying, without asking anybody. The woman, because the deal was so good, the woman did not even waste time to think. And she didn't want anybody to know what these people were doing. Yes, when you are spells and chants, you don't have head, you don't think, you lose things like that. Then, after the woman transfer all, everything, every money, everything to these people, and the people got the money, and then they disappear, the woman never see them. The stores closed down, because she was spells and chants and lose everything. And this woman, she ended up committing suicide and she died. Because of spells and chants. Even here, you know, people, when they hear something good is happening to you, they will not sleep. They will use chants, spells, and incantation to see that you lose that thing. Either you die physically or you lose it. That's what that's how witchcraft spells attack is. Chants. They will make sure that you lose the thing or you die. Physically, or you become useless. Let me pray that God will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. May God cover you, escape you. May God make a way for you to escape. Like what Paul escaped and Jesus escaped. You know, Jesus will make you to escape. All the witchcraft and the evil people around you, may the blood of Jesus cover you from them in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. They are wicked, wicked, wickedly people. They cannot sleep until they see you fail. When they see that you are going to get a good job, you are going to work in a big government office, or you are going to abroad, if you are not seek God properly, you can't go. They will kill you before you go. They will make sure that nothing will happen, nothing good will happen to you. They will spell, they will chant, they will speak evil, they will not eat. They will attack you physically, spiritually, until they see that you are finished. I am praying tonight, every evil veil of darkness be roasted by fire of God in the name of Jesus. Let the sources of the power of unfriendly friends be dissolved by the fire of God in the name of Jesus. Let the sources of your unfriendly friends, people who are close to you, you share with them, you talk to them, to talk to them like friends, you trust them. Again, they be at night, they are witchcraft, they are destroying you. Let them be roasted, let them be exposed and be disgraced in the name of Jesus. Every unfriendly friends using spells and chants, witchcraft attack, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I shake off any evil thing deposited into your body by friendly enemies in the mighty name of Jesus. Enemies that is pretend to be your friend and they say witch feeding you, even buying food and bringing you, putting spells, putting chants, putting curses, and then you eat because you trust a friend, and these things affecting you and your family. Let the blood of Jesus flush them out of your life in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray, oh God, arise in your power and confuse your close oppressors. And let God arise in his power and converse and confuse your closest friend, your enemies that are racing against you. Instead of you being confused, let them be confused and run mad in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let your enemies make mistakes that will advance your cause in the name of Jesus. Let your enemies make mistakes that will advance your cause in Jesus' name. You know, instead of you revealing secrets to your enemy, let that enemy make mistakes. that will move you forward, that will make you escape from their hands in the name of Jesus. Let your enemy make mistakes that will advance your cause in the name of Jesus. Anything that the Father has not planted in your environment, let it be uprooted. Anything the Lord has not said, if this prophet, God did not talk to him, he lied to the young prophet. Any power, anywhere that is lying against you, that the Father has not said, any false prophet you have been under, any witches and wicked pastors that is lying against you, let the Holy Ghost fire fight them. Let the thunder of God locate them and destroy them in Jesus' name. Let the thunder of God locate them. Let the Holy Ghost fire fall upon them and destroy them in the name of Jesus Christ. Listen. Satan, I breathe the blood of Jesus over this environment, over your life, over your family, over your children. I plead the blood of Jesus. Satan, leave these people. You have been attacking these people, witching them, putting spells and chants into their life. I am now praying that by the power and the blood of Jesus, I destroy you. I bind you. I command you to get out of these people. Every spells and chants you are putting these people, I am commanding them to come out from their life in Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, take absolutely control over the body, soul, and spirit of these people in the name of Jesus. My Father, my God, in the name of Jesus, I pray that God will take control over your soul, your body, and spirit. Where your body and soul and spirit has been tortured, has been tormented, let the Holy Ghost fire, let the power of God take charge over it in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, I pray that let your people surrender to you and let them change their life so that spells and chants will not locate them in the name of Jesus. My Father and my God, I want to thank you, God. I breathe the blood of Jesus. I call fire of God to burn to ashes anything that the Father has not planted in your body, anything that the Father has not planted in your life, let the fire of God burn them to ashes. Let spells and chants burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to thank you, God. Lord Jesus, my God, I pray that receive the anointing of the warrior to damage the plots of the enemies. Receive the anointing of the warrior to damage everything that the enemy has done in your life in Jesus' name. Yes, God, I want to thank you, God, my Father and my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. I call upon fire of God, to burn down anything that has been planted in your life, any power of darkness, any space and chance that has been working in your life. You become useless, you become blind, you don't see, you don't hear, that space are controlling you. Chants are working on you. They are robbing you everything. Let this power catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I charge your spiritual battle with the fire of God, of Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. I charge your spiritual battle with your Petri, with the fire of Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will charge your Petri. If you are charged with the Holy Ghost, when the spells and chants come to you, it will not function. It will not work on you. Personally, I have seen people using spells, using chants, using raining incarnation to catch me so that I can walk, I can do things they want. But they never succeed. They become sad and even they end up leaving the church and run away from me because they want to manipulate and control it. Any power that wants to manipulate you and control you, let the fire of God destroy them. There are some powers that are wicked people who comes to your life. You think that they are good, they are coming to move you forward, and they are the great enemies. They use witchcraft, they use chants to control you and manipulate you and finish you. Once they get you, they finish you completely and you become useless. They know they will come close to you. They will do everything. They will give you gifts. They come close to you, and yet they want to finish you. My God, I pray that such a people, God, my God, expose them and disgrace them. Like this prophet, he said that I am a prophet like you. And the angel of God has spoken to me through God. He lied. So those unfriendly friends, those wicked personality who come to pretend and lie on you, my God, expose them and disgrace them. Let God remove them from you in the name of Jesus Christ. Let God reveal to you that this is enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. That space and chance would not function, would not prosper in your life. I destroy them. Anyone who is being attacked by witchcraft spells, anyone who has been attacked by chance, I am praying that let that chance and spells, witchcraft, die. Let them be vanished. Let them lose their ways. Let them lose their power in the name of Jesus. I command them to be destroyed in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. I reject every involvement of the flesh and Satan in your prayer in Jesus' name. I pray that God Almighty will reject every involvement of flesh and Satan in the name of Jesus. Any flesh, you are flesh, that would give the enemy access, because people they use flesh all the time. Sometimes they forgot that they are not in the Lord. They are not saved. They are not Christian. They found they are using flesh. When you are using flesh, the enemy will get you very easily. Go to a church. Go call your pastor. If you are seeing that things, somebody is coming to you and you are seeing that you, but when you are being put spells and chants, it needs the prayer. It needs the prayer to protect you. Look at what Paul, when Paul learned Saul, by then he was called Saul. When he learned that these people wants to kill him, what did he do? He went prayer and fasting. He prayed. He was in prison. He said, God, first of all, he attacked their witches, their powers, where they are keeping their powers. That's how you pray. That's why you need to join us, midnight prayer, morning prayer. When we do the prayers, you don't know what the devil would plan to do. The devil, witchcraft, they plan so much stuff. They don't sleep. While you are sleeping them, they don't sleep. They don't even eat. They can fast and fast and fast until they finish you. May God destroy enemies that is going for fasting to destroy your destiny, to destroy your ministry, to destroy your calling, to destroy you. May the thunder and the fire of God locate them and destroy them in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, I pray that, oh God, arise. Let every evil presence around you scatter. Let evil presence around you scatter. My God, I pray that every evil presence around you scatter in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, every power blocking you from the will of God, fall down and die. Any power blocking you from the will of God, let them fall down and die in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I pray that God Almighty, any power blocking you from the will of God, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Any power that make you not to think, not to hear the voice of God, not to see, let this power be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, I am praying to you now. I pray that God Almighty will pull down every stubborn stronghold, protecting your enemies in the name of Jesus. Every power, every stronghold, every power that is protecting your enemies, let them fall down and die. That witch who deceived the young prophet, that power make the young prophet could not be able to realize that this is a witch. Let that power that cover the young prophet to be destroyed. Let those power be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I pray that no witch, no wizard, no spells, no enchants, no incense that will work in your life and your children in Jesus' name. I set them fire. Wherever is being attacked by these witchcraft powers, let them set fire. I set them fire. I set them fire. Fire of God. I set them fire and let them burn to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father. Yes, Lord. I arrest every spirit of conviction by fire. I arrest every spirit of conviction. If you are confused, you don't know what you are doing, that is spells and chants that they have put on you so that you get confused, then you follow them, you don't know the direction you are taking, I pray that let that spirit and chance be destroyed and vanish from your blood in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, even in insanity, let it be vanish in the mighty name of Jesus. I bring the blood of Jesus between you and the powers of darkness in the name of Jesus Christ. My Father and my God, in the name of Jesus, I bring the blood of Jesus between you and the powers of darkness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let the blood of Jesus wash you. Let the blood of Jesus wash your blood. Let the power and the blood of Jesus wash you and remove every spell and chance, every incarnation that they have spells on you in the mighty name of Jesus. This power is there, whether you believe or not. I'm telling you, this witchcraft is functioning, it is working, and has destroyed many, many, many lives. That's why you see, you are almost to get something. You start something very well. A lady in States not long ago, a couple of weeks, this lady, she was going to pass her test. She missed one mark like this. She failed just 1 point because of this wicked power. That's not normal. Yes, my God. Spells and chants, when it is put in your husband, your wife, they don't see anybody. They don't see you. A man can do you so wicked because of spells and chants that is operating in his life from a witch woman. That's why those men who goes to sleep with any woman, or women who goes to sleep with any man, they can get a man. I know a man. This man, he used spells and chants against women. And he's robbing women a lot of money, everything from them. And every woman, because everyone is stupid, they don't think, they don't reason. Now this man is choosing a woman he wants to go with. He line up so many women, honestly speaking, God is my witness. This man, he used spells and chants, and now he goes with wealthy women. And everyone is transferring their property wealth to this man. The man is now become very rich. And he's using that witchcraft, spells and chants. And these women, you can't talk about that man. You can't help them. Because they are under influence of heavy chants, gents, and spells, witchcraft attack. Now by the time the women will realize that they have lost everything, they will commit suicide. All that man will kill them. That's how it is. Now, I pray that every spells and chants, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I pray even those women, wherever who's been under these chants and spells, witchcraft attack, let it be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I'm telling you, I've seen things. It is true, it works. Even you can see. You can see this person. Even in the church, you see the pastor, you say the pastor does not see this. This pastor does not see what these people are doing. Because the pastor, they have put chants and spells, witchcraft attack. Now the pastor does not see anything. But you children of God, when you see this, you have to intercede and pray for your pastor. You have to pray for your church. You have to pray for the ministry. You have to pray for the church, even the choir. Sometimes the witch can use spells and chants and destroy the whole church. They don't see anything. Witchcraft are really there, and spells they use when they place a chance on a pastor, this pastor will be vanished, will be destroyed. Yes, Lord, Father, deliver your people. Yes, my God, you are so good, my God. I pray that God, anyone that being attacked by chants and spells and witchcraft spells, Lord, let it be destroyed from their life in the name of Jesus. I want to thank God. I thank God so much. I have to stop here. We'll continue tomorrow midnight. We are going to continue tomorrow midnight. We'll continue this until these powers be destroyed completely from your life. They will be destroyed completely from your family. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, invite your followers, go to the website and donate. Our website is www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. So we'll continue. It is a big staff, very heavy. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine, saying bye-bye to you. Tomorrow, midnight, we'll continue this topic. We'll continue tomorrow. Please, if you need prayers, you need me to pray with you to stop this witchcraft spells attack, call me. My number is 647-608-5207. Call me. I will stand with you and rebuke them. I will stand with you, and before you lose everything, before you come to yes, or you will end up killing yourself. That's what chants and spells, witchcraft attack, do to people. You have seen two different examples, and you have seen the examples that those who escaped and those who were destroyed, and they physically died. Yeah? So you should not be killed by chants and spells, witchcraft attack, and you can be saved from them. You call me, I will pray for you. I will stop that chants and spells. That's what is happening. People are so blind. They can't say no, they don't know, because they are not them. They are not them. They have been witched. Like the witchcraft who witched Samaria. These powers are there. Pastors are using them. Witchcraft, they are there. You found a church, the whole church manipulated by one person using spells and chants. And after that, he makes sure that he will have 3-4 airplane, and the church members, they are poor, dying with sickness and diseases. And the man is wealthy. That spells and chants they are using. It's not fun. That is the truth of the matter. Lord, may God help us. May God deliver us. May God cover us and let you be escaped like Paul, like Jesus, who escaped to Egypt and his enemy died. He came back. Let your enemies die. People, the enemy that wants to destroy you, the enemy that wants to kill you, the enemy that wants to make sure that you are not getting anything, let them die. Herod died and then Jesus came and he was not charged that he murdered anybody. Herod died. And Jesus came to live in free life until his time. Your Herod would die. Anybody that does want to see you with anything shall die in the mighty name of Jesus. Follow witchcraft that is attacking you all the time shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Yes, thank you very much. God bless you so much. Thank you for coming. Tomorrow we'll continue these videos. I'm going to abroad it. And you will find it and you will feel it. I have prayed for you and God will help you. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful time. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. God bless you. Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye.